Hey you guys, welcome back to the channel Physics Sergi, and here we are in JEE Advanced Solution Series, and I've got the 2020 paper that happened today itself, and this is from paper 1, I think question number 2. It's about EMI, electromagnetic induction, and the concept that was taken up was a very age-old experiment of Arago's rotations. Okay, so you need not know the name to solve the problem, but a very good historical trivia awaits you at the end of the solution. And please wait till the end of the solution to tell you how JEE has plucked out from the history records one of the very famous experiments which led to actually the discovery of electromagnetic induction. So this experiment is older than Michael Faraday. Okay, so let's try to see the formal wording of the question. A light disc made of aluminium, a non-magnetic material, is kept horizontally and is free to rotate about its axis as shown in the figure. A strong magnet is held vertically at a point above the disc away from its axis. On revolving the magnet about the axis of the disc will rotate in the direction opposite to the direction of the magnet's motion, rotate in the same direction as the direction of magnet's motion, not rotate and its temperature will remain unchanged, and not rotate but its temperature will slowly rise. So these are the four options. It was given in a single option correct section. So out of the four, the most appropriate one is what you are supposed to be marking as your response. Okay, so you want to give it a try, pause a minute, solve it, and then move ahead with the solution that I'm going to give. Okay, right. Oh, a lot of the things are there on the board. So just follow my lead, follow where I'm pointing, and I'll be explaining things in a very clear-cut manner. Okay, so the picture I have taken from the question suggests that this particular bar magnet is rotated around this axis. Okay, and is asking us what happens to the disc's motion. Okay, now if an observer is here on this side and watching this one in a side view, let's see what he sees. I have tried my depiction in this diagram. Can you carefully observe here? Okay, now the north pole, the magnetic field lines would be pointing inward and move into the aluminium board. And in my side view, you could see that the motion of the magnet is towards the right in this picture. Okay, so what happens? The inward lines actually increase in front as it moves within next dt seconds. These inward field lines will increase in the front direction and they will decrease in the backward direction. So let's call this front and backward directions using letters. Okay, so position one is the backward position and position two is the forward position. So I would say in the front position 2, the inward field lines will increase. So a north pole is induced to opposite. Obviously, you want outward field lines to be generated, and outward field lines means what kind of a pole would be induced here? A north pole. Okay, right. Similarly, at the backward position, you would say the inward field lines are reducing. So you need a pole which can produce inward field lines of its own. So that means a south pole is induced. So same thing, I have depicted it in the top view where I am saying the position 1 is a south pole induced position and position 2 is a north pole induced position. Now what happens? This north and the induced north pole will repel each other. Can you see a force this way? And north and the induced south pole will attract each other, and this will dominate, and the other south pole that is there also will produce forces, but this, since it is far away, this is the effective free body diagram which I have depicted here. So the 2N will have a force this way and 1S will have an attractive force towards that magnet. Okay, so the resultant of these two obviously would be a force towards right, which indeed is the motion of the magnet, which means at every new position the same thing repeats, and therefore the disc is supposed to rotate in the same sense as the bar magnet. Okay, so the resultant force is induced in the direction of motion of magnet, and that's the required solution. Okay, so go back and let's check. The best possible option among the four would be this one. Okay, the same aspect can be explained using eddy currents and all. It would be slightly longer, but in the exam situation, I would say this could be the easiest way of induced poles. Okay, so just a historical trivia about the importance of this experiment is that this was found or a similar type of, actually there were a series of Arago's rotation experiments, which this one is one of the easiest ones that JEE has picked up. Okay, so it was discovered by Arago. he could not explain why it is happening. And at the time of that discovery, they were very surprising, and people thought it was very intriguing. Okay, so but 7 years later, when Michael Faraday introduced the theory of EMI, then this particular effects got explained. So it's a very nice way that IIT has taken up a simplistic old experiment to test your understanding in EMI. Okay, so you may try solving the certain problem using eddy currents, but in the exam situation, I would suggest this is the better way. Okay, so I would try to come up with more and more solutions of JEE Advanced 2020 paper, which is slightly on the tougher side. And please do comment which questions you want the solutions in the coming days. So I'll try my best to provide them in a detailed manner. Okay, so in case you have liked the video, please do like it and share it amongst your friends. And in case you're new to my channel, do check out some 2 or 3 videos, and I'm pretty sure you would like to subscribe to my channel. Okay, see you in the next video.